फ्रेंड्स वेलकम टू youtube.com / डॉक्टर वेट चैनल। आई एम डॉक्टर पी आर पटेल, प्रोफेशनल हेड वेटरनरी मेडिसिन। इन दिस प्रेजेंटेशन वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस एन इम्पॉर्टेंट डिजीज, पोस्ट पार्ट्यूरियंट हीमोग्लोबिनूरिया। इट इज ए इम्पॉर्टेंट मेटाबॉलिक डिजीज ऑफ काउज एंड बफेलोज। In this part 4, we are going to discuss clinical findings section B. We have already discussed section A in part 3. Postmortem changes and the diagnosis of postparturient hemoglobinuria or hypophosphatemia. फ्रेंड्स, पोस्ट पार्ट्यूरियंट हीमोग्लोबिनुरिया क्लिनिकल साइंस वी हैव डिस्कस्ड इन सेक्शन ए एंड सेक्शन बी। द साइंस ऑफ एक्यूट केसेस एंड लेस एक्यूट केसेस दैट वी हैव ऑलरेडी डिस्कस्ड इन डिटेल इन सेक्शन ए पार्ट 3। नाउ इन दिस सेक्शन वी विल डिस्कस क्लिनिकल साइंस पार्ट बी, दैट इट इफ द एनिमल सर्वाइव्ड or past the acute stages and remain alive, what are the symptoms? And symptoms of chronic phosphorus deficiency. Now we will see the symptoms in animals, those animals which survive the acute stage. There is a profound weakness. We know that the function of phosphorus is to maintain muscle tone and muscle contraction. Hypophosphatemia causes great weakness. There is a recumbency in the animal, and that is because of the deficiency of phosphorus. That we have already seen. There is a effect on the rumen digestion also. There is lameness and bone disease also, because the phosphorus is an important element of mineralization of bone. If mineralization is not proper, there is pain in the bone, so there is lameness and bone disease also. Those animals survive the acute stage, they also suffer from hypophosphatemia, and they have an effect on fertility. So infertility is observed. Animal manifest pica. It is also called as allotriophagia, means eating abnormal substances. Animal eats the substances that is not normally food. There is reduction of the milk yield, retarded growth and unthriftiness, because deficiency of phosphorus affect the bone growth, because phosphorus is important element for mineralization. The convalescence take about 3 to 4 weeks or even longer. Here we will discuss signs of chronic phosphorus deficiency. Some animal may not show acute symptoms or subacute symptoms. Here the chronic phosphorus deficiency occurs mostly after many days of deficient intake of phosphorus. It is a long period of deficiency or a marginal deficiency over a quite sizable duration. We already know that the phosphorus is an important element and it causes many functions in the body. So there is multi-organ system dysfunction is observed if there is hypophosphatemia. Phosphorus is an important element of mineralization. Hypophosphatemia results into progressive, slowly demineralization of bone, and it causes osteomalacia and bone defects. The animal manifests atypical shifting leg limbness. So limbness is observed on one limb, then after a few days on the other limb, shifting of pain, change of pain from leg to leg, that is called as shifting leg limbness. Continuation of the science of chronic phosphorus deficiency. The legs become stiff and animal walks in a stiffness way and it shows lameness. That is called as stiff leg lameness. The joints are swollen. There are signs of osteodystrophia. The normal part of bone is replaced by fibrous tissue. Increase the size of joints. There is an angular limb deformities. The legs are not in a proper conformation but bend, that is angular. Overall body and trunk become a thin, and this gives you characteristic appearance, a leggy appearance to cow. Just the legs are standing, animal become thick and just like leggy, not too much body. Body is weakened. We continue the science of chronic phosphorus deficiency. There is an osteomalacia, resorption of phosphorus from the bone. And the bone is weakened to such an extent that even a slight jump or fall down may cause a fracture. So spontaneous fracture may occur. It is also called as pathological fracture. Phosphorus is an important element of the bone. So growth is affected. So there is poor growth. The hair coat and hairs are dull and rough. Milk production is subnormal. Poor reproductive performance, there is infertility. It affects the fertility. Pica, alloptrophilia, eating of the abnormal substances, eating of the substances that are not normally food, that is also observed. Postmortem findings of postparturient hemoglobinuria. There are many postmortem changes. Only few characteristic are mentioned here. The whole carcass is jaundiced because of utilization of hemoglobin. The blood is very thin and watery, and it is dark colored because hemoglobin is liberated. Because of the phagocytosis function of the spleen, spleen is swollen, the liver shows fatty infiltration, and the sinusoids are enlarged, so whole liver is enlarged. Continuation of the postmortem changes. Hypophosphatemia. There is edema or swelling of the soft tissue due to the accumulation of excess water in lower part of the body, and that is due to congestive heart failure because of the anemic anoxia. The heart pumping is very fast to pour more blood per stroke, output is increased, but at last, because of the anemic changes, the heart get tired, and that is a congestive heart failure. So edema is observed in lower part of the body. Urinary bladder contain red or coffee colored urine in urinary bladder. That is also a characteristic showing the hemoglobinuria. In this presentation, we will see diagnosis of postparturient hemoglobinuria, that is hypophosphatemia. History is important. It must coincide with the clinical signs also. History of recent calving and early lactation, especially in high producing animals. There are characteristic clinical signs within 4 weeks of parturition. There is severe hemolytic anemia, hemoglobinuria. The urine is dark red or coffee color. Animal shows jaundice. There is a dehydration because animal is not taking water, and there is diarrhea also. Diagnosis of postparturient hemoglobinuria. We have already seen clinical pathology that phosphorus level of blood is decreased, anemic changes, decrease in number of RBCs, and decrease in quantity of hemoglobin. That confirms the disease. Differentiation of hemoglobinuria and hematuria in laboratory is required because both are causing red urine. If the clinician centrifuges the sample of urine, then if the supernatant is clear, it is a hematuria. If the supernatant is pink or red in color, it is a hemoglobinuria. Also, these two conditions can be differentiated by examination of urine sample in the laboratory microscope. Hemoglobinuria, there is no RBC in urine, but in hematuria, there is presence of RBCs. Feed or pasture analysis for phosphorus deficiency, it can help to identify the toxic plants, to identify the copper deficiency in plants. Response to replacement therapy by phosphorus is also a diagnostic one. If you give the phosphorus, there is cure. It is a case of hypophosphatemia. We have already discussed the clinical signs of the hypophosphatemia, that chronic hypophosphatemia also produces characteristic signs. Friends, you are informed about the clinical findings and diagnosis. Requested to share information to the veterinary friends and to promote and to uplift the channel. Requested to subscribe the channel. Thank you very much for observing the video.